Good evening, students. Hope you are doing well in your practice exams. This is our third analysis session for English subjects. So without wasting time, we will start now discussing the question answers. So question number one, section one is language study. In that question one is write the homophone of the following. So wait. Here homophone is spelling is different, but sound is same. So wait, tell. Question number second is spot the error. And the answer is we undertake. Here in question is undertakes. So in answer, we undertakes the remaining journey in bus. Question number third is complete the compound words. Moonlight, subtitle. Question number four, identify the type of sentence. Question mark at the end. So it is very indicative. It is an interrogative sentence. Question number five is complete the following word chain of noun. Book is given. So book, kite, team, chain. Then question A2 is do as directed. Make two sentences of your own to show the difference of homograph. Train word is given. The train left before I reached the station. Second sentence, parents should train their children to be. Different meanings of train. Next question is, make a word register of four words related to the music. Music, songs, tunes, concert, pianist, singer. You can add as many as words as you want related to the music. Then third question is rewrite the sentence in present perfect tense. I have started a tea stall. Question B is pick out the modal auxiliary and state its function. So modal auxiliary in the sentence is could and the function is possibility. Question second is the prayer which he uttered endlessly came unbidden to her lips. Pick out the main and subordinate clause. So here main clause is the prayer came unbidden to her lips. And subordinate clause is which she uttered endlessly. So this is the language study. Now section two is textual passages. Five questions are there. So under the passage, there are some questions. So question answer one is, you have to select the alternative and complete it. Want to do this so that no one is left behind in a corner of the world, walk together. Here it should be walk together. Answer second is, Kaila Satyarthi feels this each time he frees a child from slavery. It is liberated. Then A2. Answer for A2 is, first one is, again, complete the following. Kaila Satyarthi recites a mantra from the ancient text of wisdom, Vedas. Then question second is, the mantra he receives has a potential to liberate humanity from all man-made crises. Then A3, match the words with their meaning. You can write answers directly in front of the word. So podium is a small platform, aspiration, an ardent wish, pursue, the action of trying to achieve something, and recall is to remember. A4, pick out the sentence with an infinitive from the passage. Any sentence you can pick. Here I have picked one. I am deeply announced to recite the mantra. Then let us recall, let us create the knowledge for all. Here you have to write, begin the sentence with let knowledge. So answer is, let knowledge be created for all. Then question five is write about various problems that children are facing. So children today have to deal with problems like high expectations from parents and intense competition from peers. They also have to face problems like pollution, antisocial elements in society, addiction to social media and video games, etc. You can write your own answer. Okay. Let's move to the second question. Question 2B. Here, complete the following web diagram. World heritage sites are in danger because of poaching, earthquakes, war, and flood. Answer B2 is complete the following. The highest number of world heritage sites are located in Italy. Second, world heritage can delete or exclude a site from the world heritage list. Next is, there are 890 world heritage sites around the world. And the last fourth one is, 36 sites have been included from India. Next question, B3. It is choose the correct meaning. So disaster is calamity and allocate is distribute. Next, B4, not only but also, not only the Opera House in Australia, but also the historic center of Vienna in Austria are cultural sites of World Heritage. Second is, you have to identify the type of sentence. It is a complex sentence. Then the fifth question is, why should we preserve World Heritage sites? So the answer is, conservation of heritage site is very important because it provides a sense of identity and continuity in fast-changing world for future generations. The heritage sites are of great importance to understand our past, our heritage, and our culture. Therefore, heritage buildings need an important tool to protect them. Next is third question, section third, based on poetry. So three questions are based on poem. The first one, A1, is the first gift was strength. The gifts or blessings lay in glass. A2 is, what did God's glass of blessings contain? The God's glass of blessings contains gifts such as strength, beauty, wisdom, honor, pleasure, other treasures, and the gift of rest. Write the rhyming words from the extract. So man can span, buy, lie, way, stay, lay, pleasure, treasure. Next, read the following poem and write the appreciation. Appreciation should be in paragraph format. So the height of ridiculous poem was given to you for the appreciation. And here is the appreciation. The poem, The Height of Ridiculous, is by Oliver Wendell Holmes. The rhyme schemes of the poem is ABCB. There are many figure of speech used in the poem, like hyperbole, onomatopoeia, tautology, alliteration, etc. But the one stands out is transfer epithet. In the line, 10 days and nights with sleepless eye, the adjective sleepless should be used for the man and not for the eye. The poem is humorous one, written for enjoyment with plenty of funny expressions. The main purpose of the poem is to simply entertain the reader. Section 4, based on non-textual passage. Here, passage was given to you and the few questions were there. So, answer for the first question is, the government authority which built and operates the Delhi Metro is Delhi Metro Rail Corporation Limited, that is DMRC. And second answer, the satellite cities nearby Delhi are Bahadurgarh, Ballabgarh, Faridabad, Ghaziabad, Gurgaon, and Noida. Question A2. The Delhi Metro is the largest and the busiest metro in India and the world's ninth longest metro system in length and 16th largest in the ridership. The network consists of 8 color-coded regular lines with a total length of 17 kilometers, serving line and interchange stations. Next question is, write the antonyms from the passage. You have to write, find out from the passage and then write. shortest is longest, increasing, reducing, irregular is regular, and ended is started. Our next question is do as directed based on grammar. So here the sentence is given and you have to write in the positive and comparative degree. So first one is positive degree. No other metro in India is as large and busy as the Delhi metro. Next one is comparative degree. The Delhi metro is larger than any other metro in India. Question 5, A5 is transportation is the backbone of Indian economy. Explain. Transportation is the backbone of Indian economy because it facilitates movements of goods or products from one place to another. It removes the hindrance of place. It helps the country for its development by carrying people, goods, and services from one place to another. It develops tourism and increases the per capita income of the people. It also helps to get the value of the perishable goods and products. So here answer 5, A5 is personal. You can write on your own. Then question 4B is read the passage and write the summary of the passage given in question 4A. So now we'll read the summary. Lifeline, we have to give the head title also. Lifeline of Delhi. Delhi Metro is considered as the lifeline of Delhi, the capital of India, which serves cities around like Bahadurgarh, Ballabgarh, Faridabad, Ghaziabad, Gurgaon, and Noida. It is constructed by Delhi Metro Rail Corporation, the Government of India, and the Government of Delhi with equal equity participation. Being the largest and busiest metro in India after Kolkata Metro, it operates 2,700 trips every day and carries 2.76 million passengers every day. It is certified by the United Nations in 2011 as the first metro rail and rail-based system in the world to get carbon credit for reducing greenhouse gas emission, which helps to reduce pollution levels in the city by 630,000 tons every year. Planning of Delhi Metro started in 1984. But Delhi Metro Corporation was incorporated in May 1995 and the actual work started in 1998. Its total length is 317 kilometers, serving 231 stations. It has three phases. The first phase was completed in 2006, the second phase in 2011, and the third is scheduled to be completed by 2018. So here students, note separate passage were given to you for summary writing. You have to write the summary for question number 4A. Then section 5 is writing skills, letter writing. So here the detailed letter is given to you, details, your address is given here in this, and the letter is write a letter to your uncle about bystanders, after them see people hit with vehicle. They have forgotten all about being human. Suggest what you expect from your bystanders. So here you have to write a letter to your uncle. So we'll start with the answer now. Question 5A1 answer. In informal letter, we write only sender's address. So here, Samira Rao, you can write either Samir or Samira. So Samira Rao, 626 Shiv Sevak, CG Road, Vadgaon, 01. 17th, and you have to date right below that, 17 January 2022. And then after that, you have to start writing a letter. Dear uncle, hope you are doing well in Mumbai. I remember that during your last visit here, we had discussed about road accidents and how bystanders react to such accidents. Having witnessed a few accidents of late, let me mention how the public near an accident site would react. When a person is hit by a vehicle, the immediate response from bystanders would be to rush to his aid and try to move him to the hospital. Depending on the severity of the accident, they might use their own vehicle or call up an ambulance, or the accident victim would be transported in the same vehicle that hit him or her. I believe this is the course to follow, and people do the natural right thing. Let me stop for now. Looking forward to more discussions when you visit us next. Give my regard to Grandpa and Auntie, and lots of love to Sweetie. Your loving niece, Samira. And then you have to write the email ID. Question A to question 5, A to is formal letter. Write a letter to the Sarpanch, Gram Panchayat office, Main Road, Wadgaon, 400001, mentioning the problem of no street lights in your area. Inform him or her about the increasing number of accidents. Request him or her to install street lights at the earliest. So, in formal letter, we always write two addresses. One is sender's address and then receiver's address. And one more is added subject. So, Samira Rao, C26, Shiv Sevak, CG Road, Wadgaon, 01, 17th January, 2022. Then, to the service. To whom we are writing the letter? To the Sarpanch. It is there in the letter. It is very indicative after two. So, to the Sarpanch, Gram Panchayat office, Main Road, Wadgaon, 01. Subject is poor condition of street lights in my area. Respected sir, I undersign writing to express my deep concern and anguish over the poor state of street lights in my locality. Almost all the bulbs have been fused or damaged. After it gets dark, moving on the colony streets is dangerous and risky. Many accidents have happened due to poor visibility. Some cases of chain and purse snatching have also been reported, and other antisocial activities are on the increase. I appeal to your kind self to look into the matter and have the street lights made functional again. I hope you will personally look into the matter and will repair as soon as possible. Thanking you, yours truly, Samira Rao, and then email ID. So, see, students, you have to write it in three paragraphs. First, introductory para, second, in detail, and last, the closing para. Our next question is information transfer is non-verbal to verbal. So read the information on the life history of Kalpana Chawla on the basis of given points. Write two short paragraphs on her life history. Suggest a suitable title. So you have to, here the information is given about Kalpana Chawla. You have to give a title to your paragraph also. So our title is First Indian Woman Astronaut. This is the title. And now, here is the paragraph. Kalpana Chawla was the first Indian woman in space. She was born in 1961 in small town of Haryana named Karnal. She completed her school studies in the Tagore Bal Niketan, located in Karnal, in the year 1976. And achieved her BE from Punjab Engineering College, Chandigarh. In 1984, she got her master's degree in aerospace engineering from the University of Texas. And in 1986, She got a PhD in aerospace engineering from the University of Colorado. After about a decade, in 1995, NASA picked her up for a space program, and in 1997, she became the first Indian American woman to go to space. She went abroad in her second space shuttle, Columbia, to study the outer atmosphere of the sun in January 2003. On 1st February 2003, the space shuttle lost contact and crashed, taking away the life of Kalpana Chawla along with six fellow astronauts. So, see, students, here you have to include all the points given here and then write a paragraph. Then question number 6A2 is verbal to non-verbal. Read the following passage and recast the information into the table given below. So here the paragraph is given about Rabindranath Tagore, and here the table is given particulars and information. So few particulars are given. I have added some more particulars and then the information about that. So you have to give the title also. So I have given the Rabindranath Tagore. You can give the life of Rabindranath Tagore. So first one is born on 7th May 1861. City of birth is Tarasankhu Mansion in Kolkata. Parents, his father is Debendranath Tagore and the mother's name is Sharda Devi. Physical activities he did, usually swim in the Ganges or Ganga River, trekking, gymnastics, participating Ludo and wrestling. He learned many things, drawing, anatomy, geography, history, literature and mathematics. Languages learned by him are Sanskrit and English. Other than those, he was Bengali, so he was good writer in Bengali also. Written works, novel, essay, short stories, travelogues, dramas, and songs. His most highly regarded works are prose and short stories. Best known collection of poem or poetry is Gitanjali. Gitanjali is his famous poetry for which he received an award, Nobel Prize, in 1913. So likewise, you have to read the paragraph. While reading it, just underline the main points, and then you can pick all those points over here and complete the table. Question number 6B is view, counter view, or drafting a speech. So first we will see B1 is view, counter view. So question is, present your views on mobile applications are a more convenient way of life. You can use the following points: increased accessibility, reach a wider audience, cost effective, automatic updates, user friendly, and time saving. By using these points, you can write a paragraph. You have to write a view. So here, do not get confused when views are written. Whatever the points are given, you are in favor of that, and you have to write a paragraph. And if the counter view is asked, it is exactly opposite. You have to write. But here in this question, the views are asked. You have to write a view. That means you are in favor of this. So importance of mobile apps. You have to give the title to your views or counter views and then start with the paragraph. The importance of mobile phones in our everyday life and activities is unending. This is so because there is ongoing tremendous information transformation in the mobile phones are no longer the ordinary communication device is used to be. The cumulative progress of mobile technology the availability and access to high-speed internet, and the remarkable communicative interface in these devices results into a whole level of new and innovative experience mobile computing. This is made possible through the development of mobile applications, that is mobile apps. Today, the availability of mobile apps is on the increase such that it is produced a noticeable change in the way human feel and experience computing. Few years ago, in order to access the internet, check and read mails, one had to use the computer. But today, this has changed because computing can be carried anywhere in mobile phones. Imagine not going to the bank, but still transfer money to family and friends. All thanks to app developers and the top phones. Imagine not going to the bank. Top app development companies. Mobile apps are unlimited in number with usage that cuts across all walks of life, with people wanting more and more of these apps for easy lifestyle and living. Presently, the use of mobile apps can be seen in areas such as communication, education, cooking, social media, shopping, etc. On daily basis, individuals seek for updated version of these apps. Hence, app developers and app developing companies are always working to keep up to date with demands. In terms of communication, many apps have developed, such as WhatsApp, Facebook, Telegram, etc., for easy and better communication with our family and friends. Today, mobile phones has become an integral part of so many individuals due to these apps, such that it could be said that it helps towards some sort of maintaining organized life. Likewise, you can write your views on mobile apps in any way. Okay. Our next question 6B is prepare a speech to be delivered by you on the occasion of International Women's Day. You may use the following points. The points are given to you. Created with equal social status, are equally capable and competent as their male counterparts, are emotionally strong and stable, and hence can cope with stress, have multitasking abilities, are worthy of respect, power, and fame as men are. So these are the points. With the help of these points, you have to write a speech. Or do not give the title to the speech. So you have to give a title to your speech. International Women's Day, the title is already given, or you can give your own title also. Yes, many students are raising their hand. Just after discussing this question, we will discuss, I will discuss your doubts. Okay, so let's see the answer. International Women's Day. Good morning, all. We have all gathered here to celebrate the International Women's Day. It is celebrated every year on 8th of March. We have gathered here to pay our respect, love, care, and appreciation to all the women present here and outside upon the hard work they do. It is not necessary to celebrate just a day, but it should be celebrated every day in the form of respect and love. Earlier, women were kept under taboo and had no recognition. They were not allowed to step out of their homes. Also, they were not allowed to work, considering them to be weak and fragile. However, with the change in time, women today have progressed and touched the moon. Today, every woman are liberate and are independent to work for themselves. They have taken over the patriarchy society and have gone much ahead than men. In my life, my sister and my mother plays a great role. It is because of them today I am standing here to speak in sound health. Women not only manage the household, but manage their works as well as efficiently. Women have concluded themselves to be no more dependent souls. Let's recognize their talents and hard work today and motivate them more for future achievements. Thank you. So with the help of points given to you, with all those points, you can write your speech and give suitable title to your speech. Yes, the last section is section 6, creative writing. In that, question number 7 is expand the theme. And our theme given to you is time and tide wait for none. So the answer for this is time and tide wait for none. You have to give the title and then write in paragraphs. Time and tide wait for none is a famous proverb which illustrates the value and importance of time. It realizes us that nothing is more precious than time. Time and tide both never wait us. We cannot stop the tide to occur in the sea. It occurs whenever it has to come. In the same way, we cannot stop or store the time for further use. It runs continuously without any stoppage. It never follows the order of anyone and never stops for anyone. It runs on its own axis without waiting for the orders of anyone. Everyone who has taken birth has to die a day, and everyone will decay. Everything will decay as time passes. Idle people always waste their time and postpone things to do in future. People who do not perform their duties on time are destroying their own lives as well as development of the nation. Time is very powerful and it punishes people who destroy time. Idle people cannot succeed in their life, whereas hardworking people always touch the heights of success. So this is how I have written on time and tide wait for none. So you can write on your own for whichever the proverb or theme is given to you. Our next question is question number 7A2. Prepare a newspaper report based on the following headline. 21 children rescued from bonded labor due to the bravery of 2 students from class 10. So first, in report writing, you have to give the headline, 21 children rescued from bonded labor. Then, who has written this? So you have to write by student reporter. Then place and date, Mumbai, January 10. In a shocking incident here today, 21 child laborers were rescued from the fire factory due to the bravery of 2 students from class 10. They were taken to the civil hospital for medical checkups. When these 2 students of class 2 saw the children working in the firework factory, they informed it to the police. With the help of that 2 students, they raided the premises of the firework factory. The owner objected to the accusation and insisted that there were no children working anywhere in their factory. However, the police were accompanied by a specially trained dog, which soon sniffed out the children who were hidden in a tiny room. They were cramped together and many were crying. It was indeed a pitiable sight, said one of the police. Many of us had tears in our eyes when we saw the condition of the little children, most of whom had skin infections. All of them were severely malnourished. The owner has been arrested and will be tried in court. So again, report writing, it should be minimum in three paragraphs. First para should be introduction, then second in detail, and then last should be the closing one. Yes. Question 7B is developing a story or narrating an experience. Here B1 is develop a story in about 80 to 100 words with the following ending. Give a suitable title. So the ending is given here. And so I learned a lesson, never trust strangers. So you have to develop a story accordingly where the ending line should be this. And you have to give a title to your story. So here the title of my story is Be Aware of Strangers. One day I had gone to a friend's place to pass the time. I did not call her in advance as I thought it's nothing important. Once I reached their place, the door was locked. I called my friend, but she was unavailable. So I thought of waiting for them to return as they don't normally go out for long. An hour or so passed and I was about to leave when a lady came up to me from one side of the floor and asked me if I was waiting for Aarti and her family to return from the market. I thought she must know them as she just said out their names. So I told her I was. She then introduced herself as the sister of my friend's father. I told her I have heard of my friends talking about things about her aunt, so I just presume it must be her. I waited together for almost another hour, talking of things. She knew so much about them that I did not doubt her identity. Then she suddenly got up and told me that she had to go to a hospital to visit a friend, but left her wallet in the house. She then asked me if I could spare her some money, which I readily produced. I gave her 500 rupees and then she left. I also decided to leave after some time. At night, my friend called to tell me that she had gone on a holiday with her family and aunt. Then I told her about the aunt I met in her building, which she denied that it was her aunt for she have only one aunt and the aunt was with them too. Then I realized that I had been duped by a complete stranger posing as my friend's aunt. I have learned my lesson to never trust strangers. So this is how you have to develop your story, and the line which is given as ending, that line should be the ending line of your story. Now the last question. Narrate an experience in about 80 to 100 words with the help of following beginning. Suggest a suitable title for it. So the beginning is given. It was Saturday and my parents were not home. Being alone, I could not sleep peacefully. And then you have to begin or develop a story. It was Saturday and my parents were not at home. Being alone, I could not sleep peacefully. To make matters worse, there was an outage. I went to the kitchen and as a lighted the candle, suddenly I saw a scorpion crawling across the floor and hide under the bed. I jumped onto the bed out of fear. Scorpion scared me to the death. I had a creeping feeling that the scorpion would climb up the wall and sting me. So I was on tenterhooks until my parents returned. Actually, they had gone to attend a wedding party. I had opted out to stay back at home to watch my favorite reality show on TV. Unfortunately, the weather got rough, followed by torrential rain. The outage had made things worse. I was scared of the dark, so I did not go out to start the generator. The sight of the scorpion inside the room had curdled my blood. It was at midnight that I heard the familiar horn of my father's car. No sooner had I heard the horn that I scampered. So this is how you can write the story. Scampered to the gate and opened it. As soon as my family entered the house, I told them the tale of my woes. My father went and with the torch saw under the bed. In the father's corner lay the scary scorpion crouching, sticking to the bedpost. My father used a broom to throw the scorpion out. I relieved a sigh of relief. I resolved I would never stay alone at home in future. So for this story, I have given the title Home Alone. You can give your own title and make your own story. Thank you. So yes, anyone has doubts? There are so many students who are raising their hand. Just you all can raise your hand now. So can you unmute the students, those who are raising hands?
Negative teacher, now we'll take queries or at last we'll take?
Sorry?
No, whatever doubts we will take at last, no?
I have already discussed all the questions actually.
Okay,
that's why.
Vishal, unmute yourself. Rehan Sheikh, unmute yourself.
Yes, students, those who are raising.
Hello, Rehan, ask your question.
Hello, teacher.
Yes.
Teacher, section 1 se wapas se paper dikhao na sab.
Section 1 wapas dekhna hai. Okay, fine. Now mute yourself. I will show you the section 1.
Okay, teacher.
See the section 1, homophone. I will explain in detail now if you want. Homophone is, there are words with the same sound. Phone indicates the sound. So homophone is indicates the same sound. So the spellings are different, but the pronunciation is same. So you have to pick up or write the words which has same sound or same pronunciation. So for weight, here two words are given, weight and tell. So for weight, you can write weight, W-A-T, weight. The pronunciation is same, but the meaning and the words are different. Then second word is tell and tell. So again, the words are different, spellings are different, but the pronunciation is same. Next, spot the error. Spot the error. Error is always there. You all know that error is always there in the verb. Wherever you have to find the sentence, verb in the sentence. So here we undertakes the. It never comes as takes, undertakes with we. It always comes undertakes and all that will come with he, she, it. So Here it is, S should be removed. So we undertake the remaining journey in bus. Then complete the compound word. Compound word is moon is given, so moonlight, then subtitle. So likewise, you can write any compound word related to that. Identify the type of sentence. Why didn't you come earlier? So question mark is given. So question mark is given, that means it is very much indicative. When there is question mark at the end, it is always interrogative sentence. A5 is complete the word chain of noun. When it is said it is a word chain of noun, you have to write only and only nouns. You cannot add verbs, adjectives, adverbs in that. So only nouns should be there in your answer. So book is given. So last letter is K, kite, E. Oh, here it is a mistake. You can write exam. Then M, exam you can write here instead of thing. And then with M, you can write money or anything likewise. So this is how the word chain. Do as directed, make a two sentences of your own to show the difference of homograph. Here train is given and you have to write the two sentences in which the meaning of train should be different in each sentence. The train left before I reached the station. Here train is a vehicle that we use for traveling, and parents should train their children to be polite. So here train is the training given to a person. So that is train. So two different meanings are there. Then word register related to the music, you have to write the words related to the music, songs, tunes, concerts, pianist, and singer. Next is rewrite the sentence in present perfect tense. I started a tea stall. I started a tea stall. So I have started a tea stall. So this is the answer. Then model auxiliary. Here the sentence is given. You could have informed the authorities about it. So could is here, that is modal auxiliary, and function is possibility. Then pick out the main and subordinate clause. So here the sentence is, the prayer which she uttered endlessly came unbidden to her lips. So here always here which is there. So when it is noun clause or relative clause, it starts with WH word. So it is indicative that here WH words, here the clauses start from WH word, which she uttered endlessly. That is the subordinate clause, and the remaining part, the prayer came unbidden to her lips, is main clause. Yes. Anyone has any other doubt?
Students can raise your hands if you have any doubt. Students, if you have any doubt, raise your hand and clear your doubts.
Yes, so many students were raising their hands. Now you can raise and ask me.
Maybe all doubts are clear, teacher.
Yes,
sir. Okay. You have completed all.
Yes, yes. All. I thought so.
Just what you can do, advice, 6:30 you can share your PPT.
6:30 in the group.
Because